أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي أفضل ما يتحلى به المسلم هو حسن الخلق وحينما مدح ربنا سبحانه وتعالى نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم فحسن الخلق سبب في دخول الجنة وحسن الخلق سبب في رفع الدرجات وحسن الخلق سبب في الألفة والمودة والسكن بين الأهل والرحمة فيما بين الناس أجمعين Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran when he talks about his character and he says subhanahu wa ta'ala bismillahir rahmanir rahim wa innaka la'ala khuluqin 'azim and you are a man of outstanding character of good manners sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says I've been sent to people to accomplish the good manners. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ وَكَأَنَّ الْأَخْلَاقِ كَانَتْ مَوْجُودَةً وَهِيَ كَذَلِكَ فَجَاءَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لِيُؤَكِّدْ عَلَيْهَا وَيَزِيدْ وَيُتَمِّمْ عَلَيْهَا لأننا نعلم أن الناس في الجاهلية أيضا كان عندهم أخلاق في جانب ما نعم كان عندهم أمور يعني سيئة لكن أيضا كان عندهم مروءة وكان عندهم شجاعة وكان عندهم كرم فجاء الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم ليعالج الأخلاق السيئة ويمحيها من المجتمع ويزيد عليها الأخلاق الصالحة الطيبة الحسنة فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق So whenever you have a good manners, a good etiquette, a good ethics, a thing that you are watching for each and every word you say to people, never hurt other people's feelings, and always feel the pain of other people, This is the way how we should dealing and how we should handling our day-to-day situations. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so gentle whenever he talks to people. He was gentle with his family, with the kids, with the people, with all people. He was sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, a man of outstanding character, a man of a good manners and ethics sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Qala Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أحبكم إلي وأقربكم مني منزلة يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا So with having a good manners in this life, struggling against all of these tribulations that we are, you know, having to deal with day and night, and always examine your heart and renew your intention, rectify your behavior, the more you are getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and never indulge into the, you know, The bad words or the bad manners, this will cause you to be so beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and even your status and your place will be so close to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hereafter, which means in paradise, inshaAllah. So having a good manners is the way for the communities actually to be in a different level of iman, of cooperation, of solidarity, of mawadda and rahmah. To having mercy amongst each other, following the way of Rasulullah Muhammad, of how he was speaking to people, how he was even giving the advice. Even when I give an advice to my kids, I need also to be gentle, otherwise they will turn a blind eye to whatever I say and just try to, you know, to escape and say, okay, I will do, but deep in their hearts, they have something, you know, it's like confronting this attack, if I could say, because actually a people never like to be having a good orders. So whenever you give an advice to someone, try also to be gentle and also to have to choose the best time and the best way and the best words to deliver the advice and to deliver the words and the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in brief, having a good manners is not something optional. We have to have a good manners and we have to develop حسن الخلق in our life Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for example, when a man came and asked him to give him a comprehensive advice, he says sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لا تغضب, never get angry. The meaning is never be affected by anger, and then you start to say, and you know, some people might curse and slander and say bad words. That's why sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he knows that most of the problems we have in the houses, and even, you know, the marriages might be exposed to, you know, to get dissolved because of this anger. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, never get angry. The meaning, never be, you know, involved by this anger and try to say bad words. Rather, you need to develop husn al-khuluq. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى كما أسلفنا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم. نسأل الله تعالى أن يحسن أخلاقنا وأن يعيننا وإياكم على طاعته وعلى اتباع نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.